Welcome to Office 2013, video number 24. Hey, if you want to download this workbook, and this workbook is for videos 23 to 27, click on the link below the video or go to our class website. Hey, we're still studying Excel. This is Excel 2013 Basics number 6. Now, this video, we're going to look at a few keyboard shortcuts. And why are keyboards so important? Because keyboard shortcuts can make you fast. This is a sure method to impress in your job interview or when you're at work. All right, we want to remind ourselves about our Control selection trick and our Shift selection trick. We've seen this a bunch of times in all of the programs we've learned, but if I select a cell and hold Control, when I click, I get to highlight things not next to each other called non-contiguous. But for this video and for a lot of Excel, one of the most powerful keyboards involves click. And before you click on the last one, you hold Shift. All right? That's our Shift selection trick. We also want to remind ourselves, keyboards, when you see them written, Control plus C means that you hold the key simultaneously. When you use an Alt keyboard shortcut, Alt PSP, we learned this in Word, and we'll see that. This keyboard also works in Excel. That is page setup dialog box. But those commas, boop, 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 mean that you hit them in succession. So you hit the Alt, and then the P, and then the S, and then the P. You don't hold them down like you would a Control keyboard. All right, here's a list of the keyboards we're going to learn. And the first question is, this is unrelated. Hey. What do the railroad tracks mean? It means the column is not wide enough, so I'm going to click and drag. Now, our first question is, how tall is this data set? So last couple of videos, we used SUMIFS and pivot tables, and we had small data sets. But most of the data sets you're going to get in your job are not very small. So I don't want to have to click and drag or use my scroll arrow. I simply want a quick way to jump to the very last part of this data set, the last row. And the keyboard is Control Arrow. Now, what Control Arrow does is we're selected D21. It just jumps to the bottom. And how does it know where the bottom is? It finds the first empty cell and stops above. So Control Down Arrow. Control Up Arrow would jump to the top, right? It jumped until it saw an empty cell and jumped back. Control Down Arrow, boom, saw an empty cell, jumped one below. Now, this works in any direction. If I left arrow, control left arrow, control right arrow, the arrow with control work in any direction. Now, if you control arrow and there's nothing, it just keeps going until it finds the edge of the spreadsheet. Control home, which is not in my list, that brings you all the way to A1. All right, so that's great. Control down arrow, wow, look at that, all the way to row 602. Control up arrow. Our next keyboard shortcut is selecting. Now remember, if I click right on this cell while holding Shift, boom, it highlights everything in between. So we're going to combine Control down arrow to jump, but if you hold Shift, it highlights. And here's our goal. We need to decrease decimals. So you're ready? Select cell D21, Control Shift down arrow. That's my favorite keyboard in all of Excel. It is just amazing. It works when you're highlighting cells. It'll work in formulas. It'll work in dialog boxes. Now, last video, we saw how to add buttons to the QWAT, and we want to learn how to access those QWAT buttons using Alt. So we learned back in Word that when you hit the Alt key, the ribbons have little screen tips, and you can get to each one of these ribbons, like Home using H, N for Insert, A for Data. But the Alt keys have numbers. That's why I always put the ones that I use the most right at the left front of the QWAT. So now it's just Alt 1, and instantly I have decreased decimals. So this is the second one, so Alt 2 would increase. Alt 1, 1 would give me 2 decreases. So Alt keys to get to your QWAT. Now, another great keyboard is Control Shift Down Arrow or in any direction highlights in a particular direction. But what about the whole table? We actually saw this earlier in this class, but it's an important one. Control Asterisk. Now you either use Control Asterisk on the number pad or Control Shift 8. Whichever one you do, it'll highlight the whole table. It looks in all directions until it finds complete rows and columns of empty cells, or if there's row headers or column headers. Now our goal here is to add a border. So instead of highlighting with our cursor and clicking and dragging forever, oh, how many of us have done that? Oh, that is painful. No more. Control asterisk or Control Shift 8. And now we can right click and go to our mini toolbar, and there's our border button. And I'm going to say, how about all borders up here? All right, so our next keyboard, the sum function is the only function of the 450 functions that has a keyboard. Alt equals, and if you forget on a test or whatever, home and hover your cursor over the sum button, and you'll see Alt equal in that screen tip. All right, you ready? Alt equals. Absolutely amazing. Now let's see that our Control Shift Arrow key works in a formula. So I select cell D21. Control Shift Down Arrow. Oh, that is amazing. That would take a long time to highlight all the way down. Now I'm going to Shift Enter. Shift Enter. Instead of Enter, that would have brought the cell down. Tab would have gone to the right. Shift Tab goes to the left, Shift Enter goes up. And of course, we know Control Enter keeps the cell selected. I'm going to hit F2. That is simply amazing. Let's try our sum if formula like we did the last two videos. So equals sum ifs. And here's the deal. We have some big ranges to put into this formula. So the sum range, as we saw, those are the numbers to add. I click on the top cell, Control Shift Down Arrow, and now F4. Now F4 is one of the keyboards we learned. We've used it in the last three videos. I don't have it in this list, but that's a pretty awesome one there. That adds the dollar signs to make that absolute. Notice how it also jumped the screen back in view. Those are the numbers to add, but if we want just the sales for this particular date, we have to give it a criteria range. That range says give me the whole column of dates. So I click on the top cell, Control Shift Down Arrow, F4 to lock it. Now I type a comma, and I'm going to use my left arrow key to get my cell reference. That's a relative cell reference. That's exactly the same formula we did last video, except for what? It was much faster. We had a huge data set, didn't want to highlight all the way down. I used Control Shift Arrow key and also the F4 key. Close parentheses, Control Enter, double click and send it down. I'm going to check the last cell, F2. I'm verifying that my ranges are looking good. All right, so keyboards really can help us. Control Shift Arrow key in formulas and with highlighting the cells and doing something like formatting. Now, what about a pivot table? We saw a pivot table last video, and we always selected a single cell. It's a proper data set. Insert pivot table. If this is something you do day in and day out, that's not the way you want to do it. You want to select a single cell. And when you're teaching yourself the Alt keyboards, you hit Alt. You look up and say, oh, it's N, so I tap an N. Then I see that it's V, so I type a V, just like that. Now remember, if you're doing pivot tables day in and day out, the first 100 times you go to insert pivot table, but at some point in your job you're like, okay, I got to learn the keyboard. Then you do it slowly, Alt, N, V. Now if you're in 2013, this keyboard is only Alt NV. In earlier versions, 10 and 7, it was Alt NVT. All right, you ready? Alt NV. That is amazing. A keyboard to get to the pivot table dialog box. Now I'm going to select existing and location, just as we did last video. I'm going to be risky here. I'm going to click right in my spreadsheet, making sure there's nothing below, and click OK. All right, so now I'm going to drag my date. And notice this is to the rows area because I've looked at my report and I say I want my dates, my criteria in rows. Wow, that is amazing. And then I take my sales and drag it to values. Again, later in the class, we'll have a video that shows how to change the function and format your pivot table. Keyboard, Alt-NV. And then the last keyboard we want to see in this video is page setup. If we Control P, oh, this is going to be terrible. Look at that, 1 of 14 pages. Well, I have my data set there, and I only want my report. When I print this, I only want this little table right here. So page layout, page setup, group dialog launcher, forget it. After doing this 20, 30, 40 times every day, day in and day out, I'm going to teach myself the keyboard. Alt, and I see that page layout is P. I see that it's SP. And even though that seems like a long keyboard, Alt-PSP, it's much faster than going from the keyboard to grabbing your mouse and going up to the page layout ribbon tab. Ready? Alt-PSP. And now I can do landscape. I'm going to make this one real big here. I'm going to do margins, horizontal. I'm going to do only a custom built-in footer, page 1 of 1, and then I'm going to come to sheet, and I'm going to say print area, and I'm going to select just that right there. Click OK. Now when I Control P, there is my report. That's a silly report. That's too small there. All right, so keyboards, they are your ticket to speed and efficiency in Excel. We'll see you next video.